It's not nice to say something like this, but now it's proven. It's a medical fact. People that are either obese or overweight during their lives will have reduced brain sizes when they grow older. 4 to 8% reduction. And that counts as severe brain damage, shrunken brains. Your brain will always shrink a little bit as you grow older, but this is quite an effect, and it really degrades the mental capacities of these people. And that should be alarming. To me, I think it's shocking. It's shocking to know that you cannot really be fat, be appreciative of your little bit of fat on your body, because it's still a big health hazard. It's a health hazard because of diabetes type 2, different types of cancers, and now intellectual degradation, which basically means that you cannot cope like other people when you get older. The reason why is this effect happening? A doctor, Mr. Thompson, suggests that it is the increased body fats that clog up the arteries, and that reduces the blood and oxygen flow to the brain, and that reduced oxygen flow causes brain damage and shrinkage. So if you eat a lot of fat, there's a lot of fat in your arteries and they don't function very well. You don't get enough oxygen and your brain cells die as a result, because they die really quickly if you have not enough oxygen in your blood. Very simple. The problem, of course, is that if I'm a school and I'm teaching children and I have a big kitchen to feed them during lunchtime, I'm often not allowed, because of the law, to serve better food, because the food industry basically cemented mandatory sale and purchase of their processed foodstuffs. So this research, if I were, let's say, more important than I am, talking into this video, but if I had something to say, I'd say, well, this really proves that fat is damaging. It's detrimental, has strong detrimental effects. So any law that mandates or facilitates serving fatty foods to anybody should be repealed or changed, so they cannot be served that fat if they are overweight. How do you even tackle this problem? How do you get everybody that's overweight back to normal weight? Or do you just accept that more than 75% of the population in the US is less capable than they could be?